Child benefit payments are set to rise in April, offering millions of households a cash boost shortly after kids return to school. The child benefit payment is rising to £21.15 a week for a family's first child and a further £14 per child for families with multiple children, Mirror Online report. The monthly benefit is paid to families on a Monday or Tuesday. Child benefit is one of many welfare payments which will change on April 6th, when the new financial year starts. As well as child support, the state pension will rise by 2.5% and universal credit 0.5%, although this could theoretically fall with the £20 uplift to be scrapped. How child benefit payments change in April 2021 for an eldest or only child. Households currently receive £21.05 per week plus £13.95 for any additional children. From April 12th, this will increase to £21.15 per week and £14 per week for additional children. This is an increase of 10p and 5p respectively per week and means the new monthly payments will be £84.60 for an eldest or only child and £56 for any additional children. The payment comes through every 4 weeks on a Monday or a Tuesday, and the claimant will also be awarded national insurance credits which can count towards their state pension. However, if a claimant or their partner earns more than £50,000 a year, a fraction of it must be repaid at the end of the tax. This is at a rate of 1% for every £100 earned over £50,000. If over £60,000 is earned in a year, the whole amount must be repaid. Child benefit for higher income families. In 2013, former Chancellor George Osborne introduced new rules to child benefit. He scrapped the initiative for anyone earning £60,000 a year or more and reduced the payout for anyone earning between £50,000 and £60,000. However, critics say the cap penalizes households where one parent earns. This is because it is based on the highest earner's salary rather than the family income. For example, a family where one parent earns £50,000 and the other earns nothing would be immediately subject. But if both parents earn £25,000 each, they wouldn't have to pay child benefit back, even though the household income is the same as where one parent is working. Even more confusingly, a family where both parents earn £49,999 would get full child benefit, even though the family income is almost £100,000. If you're earning over the threshold, you need to complete a self-assessment at the end of each tax year. HMRC will then calculate how much you owe, and bill you for the outstanding. Even though the money is returned, you'll still get a national insurance credit towards your state pension. However, be careful when you opt out as you could risk your state pension credit. If you earn above the threshold, £60,000, you must opt out officially to avoid losing any credit. When you receive the form for child benefit, you have two options. You can either take the money and pay it back as extra income tax, or you can untick a box on the application form for a zero rate child. This means that you'll still be able to claim the credits without actually receiving the credit.